Hello friends, this video on correct usage of adverbs part 6 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. To versus very. A lot of us get confused where to use to and where to use very. So let's understand that. So normally to has a negative meaning attached to it. Now what do we mean by negative meaning? I mean, not exactly negative, but yes, it has a negative meaning to some extent. Whereas very is normally used in a simple statement. So when you just want to make a simple statement, you use very. But when you want to make a statement which also has a negative impact, there you use to. Let us take this example. The box is too heavy. So when we say that, we actually mean to say that the box is so big that I cannot pick it up. Or the box is so big that it is very difficult to be picked up. So you see, whenever you use too big, that actually means that it is, you know, more than enough types. Like it is so big that I am finding it difficult. It is so big that it is causing me pain. It is so big that I cannot lift it up. So it has a negative impact in some sense. Now when we use very, we say the box is very big. So it is just a simple statement. So when I say the box is very big, that's it. Now that doesn't mean that, okay, you know, it is heavy to carry or it is causing me trouble or, you know, it has no negative implication attached. It just means that it is a simple statement. So that's the main difference between to and very. Let us take one more example. He is dash tired to study. He is very tired to study. Is that correct? Not really, because here we are not just making a statement. We are saying that he is so tired that he is not able to study anymore. So that is what we are, you know, trying to express. So here we would say he is too tired to study. And normally in sentences where we have something after the verb, like had it been a sentence where we would have just told he is dash tired, in that case we could have written very as well. In that case, he is very tired is also correct. He is too tired is also correct. But whenever you have this additional part after it, he is too tired to study, the box is too heavy to carry, the market is too far to go. So whenever you have some additional thing even after the verb, there the chances are high that it has to be to rather than very. Correct? Okay. Now let us take one more example. I am dash glad to see you. Now here, there is a catch here. What should it be? Because here also after glad, you have something after to. So I am too glad to see you. But to always has a negative meaning attached to it. But in this case, do we have a negative meaning attached to it? No. So in this case, we would say, I am very glad to see you. Right? So I think you understand the difference, right? When I say the box is too heavy to carry, that means the box is so heavy that I'm not able to carry. So it has a negative meaning attached to it. But when I say I'm very glad to see you, that is just a simple statement saying that I'm very glad to see you. Correct? Cool. So it is important that you understand the meaning in which it has been used. Right? Now also, let us look at the next example. This news is dash good to be true. That means this news is so good that it cannot be true. That is what it is trying to say, right? So that means this news is so good that it cannot be true. So you have a negative meaning attached to it, that the news cannot be true. So here we would use to. This news is too good to be true. Let's look at the next one. The work is dash interesting. So it is a simple statement. So we do not have any negative thing attached. So the work is very interesting.
Thank you. Please visit examfear.com for free quality education. You can learn with a simple 4-step learning process wherein you can watch video lessons, you can ask your questions, you can refer notes, and you can take a free online test. We have content for class 6 to 12 on physics, chemistry, mathematics, and biology along with practical videos. So please subscribe to our channel for daily updates. Thank you.